Hey, everybody. Ryan McCaffrey with IGN here. I'm joined by fellow Podcast Unlocked crew member Destin Legarry. Destin, we just got back from Los Angeles where we got our hands on this game.
That's right. Right now we're looking at Angel City. This is one of the two maps that we were able to experience.
In the Titanfall beta, which of course goes live very, very soon.
That is correct. And I believe this is my gameplay. I'm using a shotgun and I'm not very good with it.
Well, you know, we can't all be winners, Destin. So we wanted to show off each map. There are two maps in the beta. So we're looking at Angel City here, which is a fairly good-sized urban map. A lot of intersections, a lot of narrow streets. Makes getting around with the Titans a little bit trickier, certainly than in the other map that we'll see in another video, Fracture, which is very much wide open spaces. Yeah. So this is, we're looking at, you've just died there. Now we're back. We've respawned. So you're using the EV-8 shotgun.
Yeah.
EVA-8, pardon me, shotgun.
Yeah, that is correct.
In the attrition game mode, which is attrition is just their fancy pants way of saying straight deathmatch, team deathmatch, I should say. And you're trying to do a little jetpacking. You're not very good.
This is like my second game that I've played. So I was trying to get used to everything.
Oh!
And then these are some AI opponents, and we're doing another. And there's a Titan that landed on me.
That can happen. Yeah. That's
yeah.
Oh!
can't do too much about that one.
So let's talk about the map a little bit, and because obviously attrition pretty much speaks for itself. You know, one team starts on one side, one team starts on the other. You brawl it out. And we'll take a quick look at the interface as well. So obviously it shows the game type, how much time is left.
Uh-huh.
We're on the IMC here. There's the score. And
yeah.
Then see the Titan icons above the IMC and below Militia? That's
yes.
How many Titans that each team has on the battlefield at once.
Oh, okay.
So we've got two on our team plus a third one that's on that's doesn't have someone in it, but it's just out in the field. It's either in guard mode or it's just hanging out.
Yeah. So there I had to take on a Titan. It didn't work out so well, but I'm going to get to call one of my own here in any second.
Yeah, here comes or maybe that's that icon is that you can call and you're ready to call on your Titan. I don't recall which, but
I think on the
other side.
I think it's how many are ready and
how many are actually on the field. Yes.
Like the darker color.
You are correct. Yeah. That's what it was. So here you go, trying to get up the side of the building a little bit.
Yeah, it's a little tricky, like when you get in the corner. I thought I could double jump.
Yeah, at first it's
there.
A little.
And then
there
like,
you go, and you got your way up on the roof pretty easily right there.
So I was just waiting to find a good vantage point to scope out the battlefield and, you know, call in my Titan finally. And there is an enemy Titan running around, and I want to take him out because he's the guy that chased me down and killed me.
So I'm a huge fan of rodeoing the Titans, which is landing on top of them like that.
Yeah.
Nicely done, Destin.
Exactly. Well, this actually isn't rodeoing. Well, or is it,
it
when
is.
You're killing it?
It is considered. Yeah, anytime you jump on them, it's a rodeo.
So one thing they added is the opponent can tell when you're on top of their Titans now. And I was trying to take him out before he got me. But as you can see, he just used his auto pistol and just pop.
Well, you could see what happened there was the Titan stopped moving and crouched down, which was the enemy pilot getting out so that he could shoot you with his smart pistol and then get back in. So
and now it's my turn.
Yes. Now
so
it is time.
Is
it's destined time.
I'm going to embark, trying to get footage for our video editors here at the office.
You could say that your Titan fell destined time.
What?
What? No.
No, that doesn't. No.
There's the Vortex Shield in action. Which you've seen in E3 footage, you know, will block up, you know, incoming projectiles and then let you fling them back.
Sometimes you end up in a bit of a back and forth, like, you know, I shoot at him, he gets his Vortex Shield, and then, you know, we go back and forth until one of us screw up and don't have the shield and then take the damage.
Time to
so
bail.
I'm blowing up, but you've what I'm going to try and do is jump on his. I think I miss it. But, you know,
wait. You got it.
Now,
oh,
I got stepped on.
You didn't. You looks like you jumped a little early to try and get on his back there.
Yeah.
And
one of my favorite
squished.
Things to try and do is land on their Titans and blow them up.
Yes.
Yeah. There's just so much craziness going on in the battlefield. Now these are some specters, and you can actually
the AI minions. There are a couple different types.
They're kind of dumb.
They're a lot dumb.
Like right here. So three guys pop out, and I just waste them immediately.
And it's worth noting what what killing the grunts or specters, you know, those minions, those AI guys, it shaves time off of your Titan build time.
Correct.
You get a little bit of time shaved off for killing the minions.
Uh-huh.
You get more time for killing off the pilots, and you get a lot more time if you take out a Titan.
That's correct. Yeah. Yeah.
Which is shown down in the lower right corner there. You've got 41 seconds. See, you've killed some guys, and we saw the seconds tick off there. So
yeah.
36 seconds to go until your Titan is ready to go again.
And there's just tons of stuff happening constantly on the battlefield. Like, you're always looking out for the next person to shoot or the next pod to drop. And, you know, it's pretty crazy.
Yeah, we're here. So let's talk more about this map. I really like this map a lot. You're using a shotgun here, which is interesting. I found myself favoring, you know, because when you first start out in the game, you know, I think you're probably only level one or two here. You've only got a choice of three weapons, or three loadouts, one of which includes the smart pistol, one of which includes an assault rifle, and one of which includes the shotgun here.
Yeah.
And I feel like this map, I've preferred the assault rifle because it's just sort of a good all-around mid-range weapon. You don't really do any long-range combat on here on this map right away until later. What's interesting is you'll unlock a sniper rifle eventually for a loadout, and then you can start getting up on top of the big rooftops in this map, and it really changes the dynamic of the map once you get some guys that are leveled up and can start sniping out from the rooftops.
Yeah, for this map and game type, definitely the assault rifle is the better way to go. Like I said, this is my second game, so I was just trying everything out, and trying out my Titan.
Oh, I think you win.
Yeah.
I think you won that battle.
I was hoping that I could get him in the window, but I didn't. Yeah, so I was trying out the shotgun, and it works a lot better in a hardpoint, which we're going to look at shortly.
Yeah. You're also, you've chosen one of the three default Titan loadouts here, in which, it blew up, but you had the chain gun there. There's also a quad called a Vortex rocket launcher, which shoots four very slow-moving, swirling barrage of rockets.
Uh-huh.
And then finally, the one I favored, which was sort of almost a Gauss rifle type thing, which fires bigger, sort of slower shells, quick shells, but they're a little smaller. They're not as big as the rockets. And there you go.
Everybody kept running up to this rooftop, so I'm like, well, I'll just stay here and
wait.
Yeah, so what we're trying to do right now is intercept the ship that's about to land.
Yeah, you've already won here.
Yeah.
If you win, you're trying to stop the enemy team from escaping. If they escape, they get a little extra experience.
Yeah.
So as this match ends, we'll now we'll about to take a look at the other game type for this map that's in the beta, which is Hardpoint Domination.
Right. Let's hop into that.
Okay, same map, but let's play Hardpoint Domination here. Which, it really changes the dynamics of the map in a way I really found interesting. So it's nothing you haven't seen before. We got three control points. Mm-hmm. Each team is vying for control of all three. And, of course, first one that reaches, you know, you get points for each one you hold. And, you know, the more you have, the faster you tick off more points. So it's a tug of war. And the first team that reaches the point cap, which is 400, wins. So here right away, each team starts near one point, and then there's the point in the middle, and then the tug-of-war game starts. And here you are starting, Destin. You've decided to start here with the assault rifle.
Yeah, again, this is my third game, just trying out all the different weapons to get a feel for them. We play quite a bit by the end of the day, but early on I just want to get a feel for all the different types. And for hard points, the shotgun is definitely a good selection.
I completely agree on this map.
Yeah.
We'll see if you watch our Fracture video later, I actually prefer, I think the smart pistol is fantastic for a hard point on that map, because you can really, there's a lot of open space to lock in on the guys with the smart pistol, but here, we're already seeing how differently the map plays, the same map, because we're seeing you hang out indoors, and all the capture points are inside in some, whether like really indoors, like this is, or a couple of the other points, specifically point C is like just kind of in a hangar. It's like pseudo outdoors.
Yeah, I don't even worry about point C, because I'm like, well, if we can hold the A and B, then they're not going to be able to do anything against us. And
so you gave a kick salute to your team.
Yeah,
right
yeah,
there.
That's what I was doing.
But yeah, so the game does change quite
kind of
a bit.
Shot.
Oh, and then you
before
get
before I get my neck broken
from behind. Yeah, yeah, a little execution. It is worth noting for you Call of Duty fans. Yes, you can melee execute people by clicking in the right stick in this game, but the range is you have to be right up on
yeah.
them. You can't. It's not like Call of Duty where you can hit it from 6 feet away and you'll lunge in and stab them to death.
Yeah, so I've taken a bit of a Titan also. I have the chain gun this. Oh, wait, did I have the chain gun last time?
You didn't. So, yeah, you're still with the chain gun.
But he had a different paint job, so, you know, it's like he's all rigged.
Yeah, and we're looking at, so you can see on the bumpers the different Titan abilities.
Uh-huh.
Damn it, Destin, stop getting out of your Titan. I'm trying to explain things. But the Vortex Shield was on the left bumper that we already uh-huh. saw, and on the right bumper, I forget what you had already.
I don't know. I'll get back in it a little bit.
Oh, it was
right
the missile
now,
barrage.
The
default missile barrage where it just fires a volley of rockets.
Yeah.
And those are on cooldown timers and they recharge. Just like here, you've got on your left bumper on foot as a pilot, you've got a cloak.
Yeah.
So you did use it earlier. We are not seeing it at the moment. But
uh-huh.
again, same thing. It's on a cooldown timer. It lasts for a little while and then takes a few moments to recharge. But
yeah.
So you're just hanging out at point B here, trying to make sure it's locked down, and you failed. Way to go,
yeah.
Destin.
Yeah. So that's point B. There are two other points. Point C is in the hangar. This might be Bobby's footage, actually. I don't know if this is mine.
If we're failing, it's Bobby, right?
Yeah. It's Bobby's fault.
So now, yeah, we're over near point A, and we're uh-huh. running towards. You can see our team here doing quite well.
Uh-huh.
We've got A and B, and we're currently vying for C.
Yeah.
Heading right back up to point B.
Yeah, this
point
is Bobby.
B.
This is me. I would have went to C by now.
Damn it, Bobby.
Oh, here he goes. He's going.
Oh! He just looked at that Titan and exploded. Did you see how good Bobby
That's
is?
That's how good he is.
Here's one of the – now, each pilot – also gets an anti-Titan weapon if you
uh-huh.
press left on the D-pad on Xbox One, and probably the Xbox 360 version, I would suspect. So, you know, you've got two weapons, a primary weapon and a secondary weapon, but then also left on the D-pad pulls up your anti-Titan weapon, which in that case, you know, you've got a choice of a few different ones and you'll unlock more as you level up. That was a rocket launcher where you have to really hold it down to get a lock on, but then it fires a nice, super powerful shoulder-mounted rocket at the Titan.
Yeah. Come on, Bobby, go over to point
C. Yeah, let's get something.
Oh,
he was trying to whip out that rocket launcher. That's not gonna work on a human target. Or I mean, it will, but it would take forever. So you spawned over at A.
Uh-huh.
We've got A.
Yeah, A is your spawn point, so you capture that immediately.
And that Titan is, yeah, not
yeah.
long for this world. Here we go.
Okay, using his rocket launcher again.
That's...
Get it.
That's a friendly. Get it.
Nice.
Yeah, and now he's been making some kills. He's ready to call in his Titan should he decide to do so. Oh, ripped out the pilot on that
one. Yeah, so he's called in his Titan. He's going to hop in it here in just a second if he doesn't get taken out. Now he has a shield. He can hop in there and do some work, so to speak.
Yes. Let's see where he opts to go. But yet again, so on hardpoint domination, the Titans play a very different role because the Titans mostly cannot capture the points because the points are located indoors, and you have to be fairly close to the capture point in order to get it. So the Titans here serve a different purpose. They either, you know, you're either defending the point you've already captured, or you're just sort of using it to try and clean out, you know, do some violent reconnaissance work on the point that you want to capture. But then you've got to disembark from your Titan to hop out and jump in there and get it, which is what Bobby is doing now.
Yeah. There he is. He's back at B, capturing point B. Bobby has an interesting play style. He doesn't do a lot of rooftop jumping.
No.
You know, I think it's because he's a big Call of Duty player, and
yes.
he's kind of used to staying on the ground. You know, it's going to be interesting to see how Call of Duty players, you know, take advantage of the new abilities available to them once they get used to it.
Yeah, that's actually a good point. We're not, you know, Bobby, and by his own admission, if you listen to his Bobby videos that we also have up with him playing Titanfall, you know, you will see, I guarantee, when you start playing the game during the beta and or the final version, early on, not a lot of people were jetpack because they're just not used to doing it. They're not jetpacking. They're not wall running. It's something you kind of have to get used to doing and remember, oh, yeah, okay, all I have to do is hit jump and I can do this pretty easily.
Here's point C. We finally got a look at it.
Yeah, we're getting over to the hangar. Now, this one you can bring a Titan over into, and we just got assaulted by a Titan round. But yeah, spawning back at A. So you can see there are just a lot of different ways to play this, and it does vary just on this one map, and it does vary based on what the game mode is. So that's one thing I really, really like about Titanfall so far, is even on the same map can play very, very differently depending on not only your play style, but the game type. You know, the game type can dictate how the map is going to play.
Yeah, I actually really enjoyed Hardpoints quite a bit.
Me too.
It's really fun. It's hard to decide. Which did you like more, attrition or Hardpoints?
Well, I mean, you know, attrition is just straight team deathmatch, which is what we've all been doing for 20 years. And it's certainly fun in Titanfall, but yeah, I liked having the objective because, for me, you know, I'm not the most skilled player. I'm a very kind of average player, I would say. And so I liked in having the objective here in Hardpoint Domination so that even I could still be successful and help my team even if I wasn't actually getting a ton of kills.
Yeah. So there, Bobby's captured C, and as you can tell, it's a very enclosed space, but you have some areas back here where you can kind of hide.
Yeah, and he's using his cloak, too.
But because the Titans can get in there, it gets really crazy during the match. He's managing to hold it, just kind of, you know, camping out, making sure that his teammates are okay. But he's realized he's lost point A and B, and he's heading back over there.
And so we've got a pretty good tug of war going on in this match. As you know, his team, we've only got 1 point, the other team's got two. And we're ahead 308 to 270, but that score is getting closer and closer since, you know, the other team has two of the 3 points. And, you know, we were in some pretty good matches, some really close matches during our time with the beta early on.
Yeah, which, I don't know, the game's just really, really fun. You know, a lot of close matches.
Yeah.
I never really felt like I was getting dominated at any time.
I agree.
You know, it was always really close and really exciting. Just the fact that you can go from this on-foot game to being a sniper, like on a rooftop, or just picking people off, to you're in a big mech and you're just... You know, you don't really care about the little players. You care about the bigger threat of the Titans. It's a really interesting gameplay
dynamic
for the player.
Totally agree. So we've got a lot more coming on Titanfall. A million videos up on IGN. Hope you'll check all of them out. So for all things Titanfall, whether you know we're live streaming the game, whether we're digging into all the various game modes, we've got it all for you right here on IGN.